Today we're going to make a fantastic multicolor keychain that prints face down, so let's get cracking. Of course, we'll be using Tinkercad that you can find at tinkercad.com. This is where you can find your designs. Today's project is based on one I started earlier. It is a three-color keychain. I made this fun Pistons keychain with three different layers, so that way we could print it with multicolor super quick. If you have not completed it yet, it does come with a template. You can find that tutorial with the bit.ly up above or using the cards in the video. So let's convert this to print face down. First, I never like to wreck what I built, so I'm just going to do Control D and Shift Nudge to move the original off to the side. Now the original keychain was 2 millimeters thick. I like that. So I'm gonna do Shift Nudge and move it to the side. Notice there is also a back part that I wanna move to the side as well. And then I wanna take those two and do Control G to group them. They are now a union group. You may notice these little artifacts right here. I'm going to tell you, you can ignore them. I'm now going to take each of these shapes and I'm going to set them to 0.5 because I want to print this quickly. Now the white filament I used was a little bit transparent, so we may find out that I need to make these 1 millimeter, but I'm going to try 0.5 first just because it prints so much faster. These were made using SVGs. Of course, you can learn all about that in the original tutorial. This 1.5 is important because check this out, that did not exist with that SVG. It's just not part of it. You could have had that for many letters. I only had it from the O. Let me show you how I drew it really quick. It was simply bringing out the sketch tool, dropping it in a 20 by 20 grid, moving over to where the O was, and then I'm gonna use the Bezier curve. Press number 2. I'm going to set my nudge to off so I can get closer to the edge of the letters. And I'm going to start from the top middle. I'm going to move over to about the middle and I'm going to click, hold, and twist to get it close to that line. Notice right now it's going on both sides of the line. I don't care about that. I'll fix it in a minute. Once again, I'm going to about the middle and it was close, but I could have clicked, hold, and twist to get it a little closer. I can also edit it when I'm done. Once again, click, hold, and twist to get it close. And then finally, click, hold, and twist to get it close up at the top. When I'm done, I'm gonna switch to the stroke. And this is where I mentioned that 1.5, maybe 1.4. You can adjust those as much as you want. Notice it automatically went to the inside line, which is perfect. It's gonna overlap a tiny bit. I don't necessarily care about that, but I will show you how to edit. Right now, these are smooth curves, so they both adjust the same amount. I'm going to do Control Z, and I'm going to hit number 3 to make them a broken curve. That way, this top one stays the way it was, and I can adjust the bottom one to the perfect spot I want. I'm going to double check this over here. Once again, 3 to make it a broken curve. That wrecked both of these, but I can quickly get this back to where I liked it. I think that's all right. And then this one, I'm going to just nudge it until it's closer to perfect. Same thing up here. Let's hit 3 to break it and adjust it until I'm happy as well. And let's finish the sketch. Of course, we need to set the height of that to 0.5. I'm going to set it to the red. I will show you this real quickly. I'm going to click on the original red I used, double check the color, copy it, move to that other part. Of course, click, custom, double click, and Control V to paste. Now I'm going to grab these two, shift select, and I'm going to do Control D, shift nudge, so you can see they're different. Of course, the nudge is tiny because I had the settings to off. I'm going to set that back to 1, and I'm going to do Control G to group those. They are now a single piece, and I'm going to make them a whole. Same thing for the white. I'm going to do Control D. I'll do Shift Nudge to move it out. Notice it's real easy this time because I had the snap grid back to 1, and we're going to set that as a whole. Now let's line this back up. I'm going to Shift Nudge to move it back. I'm going to quickly grab all of these, choose L for a line, make the blue one the boss, and I want everything to come to the top. You'll notice the original words that were right here, they are already lined up, but their holes are not. We are going to quickly click on these colored parts and we're going to lock them. You can also use the shortcut L for lock. Make sure you also get any of those holes you had to draw. And then we're going to find the white one. Notice you can double check the color to make sure you grabbed it. We're going to lock it as well. grab the rest of these parts, L for align. Once again, let's make the blue one the boss, and we need to choose center and top. Of course, those were already there. Now that everything's in place, we can grab it all. Notice I did get that centerpiece and do Control G to group. Notice all the parts show up right now because we just cut out the holes where the red and the white exist. That is the entire trick. All right, so let's get this ready for exporting. First, I'm gonna click only on the blue. Choose export, selected shape, STL, and then I'm gonna save this piece instead of three color. I'm gonna just make this say BL for blue and save those changes. I'm also gonna hide that part so it limits the parts we have on our screen. I'm gonna now click on the white one because it's the easy one. I'm gonna choose export, STL. Once again, it's only the selected shape. I'm gonna steal that name, but I'm gonna put a WT in front of it so I remember this is the white one, and hit save changes. Of course, now we can hide that as well. The reason we did this is because we've got two parts right here. Now I do wanna take this one and unlock it. Grab the two, choose export. This time we have two shapes and STL. Once again, I'm gonna steal the name, but of course here, we're gonna put red and save the changes. At this point, you can move to Bamboo Lab Studio. We're gonna create a brand new project. I've got the P1S. My four colors are loaded. I've got it set to advanced. I'm gonna quickly hit add, and we're gonna grab all three of those at once. When we choose open, I'm gonna say yes, I want single object, multiple parts. I'm gonna quickly switch to the object mode, and now we can match up the colors. Click, click, make it red. Click, click, make this one white. Just like that, bang, we've got our colors. Now I do know we could use the OBJ files, but I do not like how I have to unzip them. This just seems as efficient to me, and it's how I choose to roll. Now the final step is to simply grab our project, and we need to flip it so it's face down. Once again, grab the green one. If you stay inside, you can snap, pop, 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 and you are ready for 3D printing. If we zip back to the global process, I'm gonna use the 0.2 standard. Let's slice the plate. Notice it's gonna take about 35 minutes, and let's print the plate. Double check those colors, and let's send it to the 3D printer. And a little more than 30 minutes later. How cool is that? Even at 0.5 millimeters, that showed up fantastic. Now real quickly as I wrap up, of course, if you missed the first tutorial, it'll be up in the cards. Of course, if you're just starting out, I'll have my day one tutorial list up there as well. Friends, I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. There are also members only posts. Make sure you keep an eye out for those as well. A massive shout out too to everybody that supports me via Patreon. Love of that group is growing. We are way past 300 members. It is a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, post designs, and gain skills. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you like, hype, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.